time. We finally really did it. You maniacs! You blew it up! Oh, damn you! God damn you all to hell!
All right, shalom, shalom. Give a round of applause to Charlton Heston for representing the nation of Esau, man. All right. That was some grade 8 acting back then, man. First and foremost, I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, Wahara Kakwadash. Double honors to my apostles and elders at Great Millstone, the men that taught me this truth through the Spirit. Peace and blessings to you, brothers, teaching this word in the truth and sincerity. Peace and blessings to the rest of the believers and followers of Yahweh Bahashim, Yahweh Shai, scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. All right, the name of this show is going to be God Damn You All to Hell, right? And this was inspired by that clip that you just seen from the movie Planet of the Apes that came out in 1968, right? Director Franklin J. Schaffner, right? And, man, that, you know, I seen that movie before I came into the truth. And I was, like, astounded, like, astonished. Because I'm like, oh, shit. I'm like, white people in chains. What the hell? This is some crazy shit. And that was even, you know, before the truth. And then coming into the truth and having the understanding of the scriptures, those movies have a whole new light to it, you know? And that scene, that last scene, shows that they know the route that this world is going in. They show that they know the events that's going to happen on the planet Earth. Because contrary to popular belief, the elites know about the scriptures and they know about prophecies. And contrary to popular belief, movies aren't just about entertainment. All right? Messages, signs, and things done on the left-hand side, all right? But God damn you all to hell, man. I gotta play that part one more time.
We finally, I'm home. All the time.
He just came to the realization that he thought, you know, he was in this other dimension, this, you know, this other place that wasn't even Earth no more, but he realized that he was on Earth this whole time.
We finally really did it.
See, you finally really did it. Knowing that mankind is the reason, well, not even man, Edomites, which Edomites is the nationality of you so-called Caucasian people, right? You are the downfall of the planet Earth. You are the reason why there's so much war, chaos, destruction, no peace on the planet Earth.
You maniacs! You blew it up!
Yes, I love this scene, man. You maniacs! You blew it up! Because these fucking, it shows you that this is the devil and that this is the wicked that rules the planet Earth, because all they can do is destroy. Their whole MO, their whole purpose of being is about destruction. Remember, the blessing that Esau received was the sword. And he's using his blessing to the fullest. Even to the point of his own destruction.
Oh, damn you! God damn you all to hell!
And that is accurate. That is accurate as hell. All right? Because contrary to popular belief, hell is not a place where you burn forever. Hell is not a place where after you die, your soul descends to the deepest parts of the core of the earth or the spirit realm where your soul is tormented and burned forever. Heaven and hell is conditions played out on earth. All right? Heaven and hell is conditions played out on earth. All right? Real quick, before I get this. This is Revelation chapter 20, verse 14. Yep, it says, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire, right? So death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. How can hell be cast into a lake of fire, right? How can hell, a place that you burn forever, be cast into a lake of fire, a place that you burn? So obviously, when the scriptures speak about hell, it's not talking about the mythos or the fable that was created by the Roman Catholic Church. It's not talking about what your churches teach what hell is. Because if there was a such thing called hell, who's in this hell? Who's in this hell? One. Two. Who in the Bible went to hell? All right. So it says, and death and hell were cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. The second death is in reference to the nuclear destruction that's coming up, this up and coming third world war, right? The end of this movie scene, Charlton Heston realizing that he was still on Earth, even though he was still on Earth, and that he saw the Statue of Liberty destroyed, right? He basically was on a wasteland. That's the future of America. It's going to be a giant wasteland. You ain't going to be able to tell that you was in America, even though there's not going to be nobody that dwells in America according to the prophecies. But you ain't going to be able to tell where New York was, where Chicago was, where Atlanta was, where Canada was. You ain't going to be able to tell where any state or border was at, because there's going to be that great of a destruction in this land. All right, now let's get the scriptures. God damn you all to hell. Because God is going to damn America to hell. God never blessed America. God damned this place. And he will damn this place with thermonuclear fire. All right, Isaiah chapter 24, verse 4. The earth mourneth and fadeth away. The world languisheth and fadeth away. The haughty people of the earth languish. All right? It says, the earth is also defiled under the inhabitants thereof, because they have transgressed the laws, changed the ordinance, broke the everlasting covenant. So the earth and the inhabitants, it's completely defiled, right? The people on the planet Earth, the people that's ruling the planet Earth, is defiling the Earth, polluting the Earth by the ways of GMO foods, chemtrails in the air, poison in the water, right? Putting spells upon the people through their TV and social media, completely brainwashing the people. Right? The earth is also defiled under the inhabitants thereof. And how do you become defiled? By breaking the laws, statutes, and commandments of God. Right? Therefore, because they have transgressed the laws, the the whole earth, nobody is keeping the laws of God or the word of God besides his elect, right? Nobody is keeping God's sayings besides his chosen people, which are you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, starting with the elect, right? Changed the ordinance, broke the everlasting covenant, right? It says the earth suffers for the sins of its people. They don't keep the land Sabbath. They're drilling, they're taking the blood of the earth, which is the oil, which keeps the plates of the earth lubricated, right? They drilling the earth dry, sucking the earth dry, right? They completely, they're doing away with the natural fruits and plants and genetically modifying new fruits and plants. Everything that they're selling to the people is made up in a goddamn lab. There's nothing grown naturally, right? It says, for they have twisted God's instructions, right? Man shall not lay down with mankind, for it is an abomination. They shall surely be put to death. They give these people's rights. They give them rights to change their gender, to chop off or to put on certain private parts. It says, violated his laws and broken his everlasting covenant, right? Therefore, have the curse devoured the earth. What's that curse? The second death. What's that curse? Hell, right? And they that dwell therein are desolate. That's why when you watch the movie Planet of the Apes, the only people that was left were slaves. The only humans that was left were slaves. And they didn't even have a language. They was grunting like cavemen or beast, right? Everybody else was gone. They was dead. It says, and they that dwell are desolate. See, they that dwell are desolate. Therefore, the inhabitants of the earth are burned and few men left. And the few men that's going to be left is going into hardcore slavery. Just like in the movie Planet of the Apes. Everybody else, after this great destruction of the day of the Lord, right? And then the Lord is going to return with his army of chariots, which are the so-called UFOs, and they're going to continue to cause more destruction on the planet Earth. Whatever men are left are going into slavery, right? And then you got certain Christians and theologians, well, that's not biblical and that's not in the Bible. Well, they said it was biblical when they put us in slavery. They said that was manifest destiny. They said that was manifest destiny in the will of God. Like they came over here to the Americas and take down the indigenous Indians from North South, the indigenous Americans of North Central and South America. Right? They said that was destiny. Well, guess what? It's going to be payback, right? It's going to be recompense, and it's going to be our destiny to put you so-called crackers in slavery. So it says, therefore the inhabitants of the earth are burnt and few men left. It says, oh, that was it on that. One more scripture and I'm going to wrap it up. Isaiah chapter 34 verse 1. Come near, ye nations, to hear and hearken, ye people. Let the earth hear, and all that is therein the world, and all things that come forth of it. For the indignation of Yahweh is upon all nations, and his fury upon all their armies. He have utterly destroyed them. He have delivered them to the slaughter. Right? Because all the nations, they're going to try to come together. Just like Ronald Reagan said, Bill Clinton said, and I believe George Bush Sr., I believe, right? There's going to come the day when we all going to have to come together, right? We're going to have to stop fighting each other, and we're going to have to fight forces from above, right? It says, for the indignation, which is the righteous anger of Yahweh, which is the name of the Heavenly Father, is upon all nations, and his fury upon all their armies, right? Yet they durst fight. He have utterly destroyed them. He have delivered them to the slaughter. Their slain also shall be cast out, and their stink shall come up out of their carcass, and the mountains shall be melted with their blood. And that's going to happen, this up and coming Third World War. There's not going to be, there's not going to be nobody to bury their bodies. There's going to be so many dead bodies that it's going to be hard to, in Slovakia, just lost track of my thought. It's going to be hard to bury all the bodies that's going to come when the Lord returns. It says, and the mountains shall be melted with their blood, and all the host of heaven shall be dissolved, and the heavens shall be rolled together as a scroll, which is that thermonuclear destruction, right? It looks like a mushroom cloud or a scroll that's unrolled. It says, and all their hosts shall fall down as the leaf falleth off from the vine, and as a fallen fig from the fig tree. You're just going to drop, right? You're not going to stand. When the Lord returns, right, you're going to try to fight, but the Lord is going to be killing you so easily. He's going to be taking your forces out so easily. It's going to be like a leaf falling from a tree or a fig falling from a vine. Vice versa. For my sword shall be bathed in heaven. What is the Lord's sword? Isaiah 54:16. Behold, I created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire and make an instrument. Salaka, let me just get it. Salaka, Akim, Wa Akwaf. Got like a little cold. Isaiah 54:16. Behold, I have created the smith that bloweth the coals in the fire, and that bringeth forth an instrument for his work, and I have created a waster to destroy it. So the Lord's sword that shall be bathed in heaven is the waster that's going to destroy. It says, for my sword shall be bathed in heaven. Behold, it shall come down upon Idumea. Right, Charlton Heston, and upon all the people of my curse to judgment. All right, and let's read it in the NLT. And when my sword have finished its works in the heavens, it will fall upon Edom, the nation I have marked for destruction. Says it right there, man. You so-called white people, you Caucasian people, you are the ones the Lord marked for his destruction. And that's why America is going to go out in a blaze. And all the nations that contain into the continental ballistic missiles, all the nations that partook in the destruction of the planet Earth and the destruction of the Lord's people, you are marked for the destruction of the Lord. I pray and hope that you was edified. I'm going to give all praise, design, and glory to Yahweh. Bahashim Yahushai, Wahavakakudash. Till next time, I say Shalom.